Good evening. It's 20 past nine on a June evening, British summertime, so it's light in England until about 10 o'clock. And what we're doing today is very deliberately waiting until this time of day, as we have to, for the sun to set. I'm at Aldrington, just to the west of Brighton. I haven't got a train here. I've driven here. I will be driving home tonight in about an hour's time once we've done our thing that we're going to do, but hoping to see a train pass through. And I say we, I'm going to go and meet my friend Seb, who should be down there somewhere setting up. And the thing about Aldrington and the reason why I've chosen this station is that last week I put a thing out on Twitter saying, does anybody know of any stations in this area, because Seb lives in Brighton, that don't have DMIs, dot matrix display indicators? And we got a few answers back, and we thought that Aldrington might not have any at all. But then we found out, we realised that they do have them. There's one over there and there's one here. But the thing about Aldrington is that they have these really long paths. It takes about a minute to walk from the entrance up to the platform level, and that gave us the idea that this would be the perfect location to do the thing that we want to do. And if you look, I'm on the westbound platform, and if I turn slowly around, the platforms you'll see are staggered, but the paths on either side come out to the street at the same point, so the walk up to the eastbound platform is even longer to get to this slightly staggered platform here on the eastbound side. You can see in the distance there is the dot matrix for the eastbound platform. Amusingly, it's outside of the fence, I think almost outside the boundary of the station, and then overhangs inside the station because the platforms are quite narrow. But that's quite a long walk from where the platform, the station truly starts, down to where the entrance is at the street, down that path over there. This great passageway corridor. Ah, someone's done an NHS, thanks to NHS. And I'm here to meet the gentleman who I can see is already here, keeping his social distance. This is Seb, full name?
Seb Lee-Delisle.
I mean, we're gonna plug his YouTube
you can
channel.
Just say Seb Lee if you like.
Can I call you Seb the Laser Guy, which is how I
get that?
That's who you are in my contacts.
Worst
in my phone.
Superhero name ever, but sure.
That's a great superhero name. So here's the thing, Seb is, well, he says laserist. I'm going to call him like a digital laser artist. He does ridiculously cool things with lasers. Just last month, we're mentioning the NHS rainbow there. There's a video clip I can cut to where Seb in Brighton projected the NHS logo. What building was it on the side of?
Oh, it was on Sussex Heights.
So the Sussex Heights building. If you've seen that clip, it went a little bit viral on Twitter. That was Seb. And for ages, he's got his own YouTube channel running, and we've been talking for the last year now, and we're like, one day we should get around to doing like a railway versus laser thing, and we were trying to come up with an idea, and then when we got the idea, it was obvious, and we thought, I don't know why we didn't think of it sooner, and Seb, right now, is creating some train times using his laser. And so the reason why Aldrington became perfect is because when you start here at the entrance, the ramp up, the long walk up to the platform, there's a sign saying welcome to Aldrington, but there's no next train information. So what we did is that we spoke to our friend Russell at UK Departure Boards. He's the gentleman that lets you have your own dot matrix departure board at home. I'll put a link in the description to him. We've tapped into his feed. Thanks, Russell. Seb has taken that feed and he's basically, we're going to ask him in a second, feeding it through his box of wizardry, laser wizardry, and is now projecting, quite amazingly, down here for anyone to see at this level what the current time is and when the next train is. So we've created our own dot matrix departure board using lasers, and that is fantastic. So Seb, keep it simple for me.
How are you making this work from the feed from UK Departure Boards?
Okay, so keeping it simple. Everything I do gets very complicated, so it's a bit confusing. So let's break it down. So I've got laser code. I can draw anything I want with my laser code. Shapes, patterns, whatever. In this case, I'm projecting some text, and there's a whole bunch of nerdy detail I can go into about this specific font, I can tell
you. Well, you'll do that on your video,
I'll
right?
Do that on
I can
my
see,
video,
okay.
Yeah.
If you click up here for Seb's video on that, yeah, go on.
Yeah, so I've got the code that can figure out the path the laser needs to make to draw that stuff. So then I've actually, for the first time ever, I'm running my code on a Raspberry Pi. That's down there, it's a tiny little computer that's running everything. And that's tethered to my phone, and my code is also calling Russell's API to get the data for the next train specific to Aldrington, and then projecting it up there.
Like, is it like a USB, or is it a serial link? How do you actually, you know, what sort of format is it? Is it a text file, or is it like, is it like a script that you've written?
Okay, so with lasers, you need to specify, because that's just one laser beam, right? But it's moving around so fast, it's drawing.
Is it literally
pictures.
Saying like, go up 50, right 20,
yeah.
down 90, that
yeah,
kind
exactly.
of thing? It, yeah,
exactly. But it can't jump too far. It needs to split up that line into little movements. And it needs to slow down in the corners, otherwise it just cuts around the corners. So it's quite a lot of maths involved. So it communicates with the laser through USB. This particular laser has got a built-in controller, so I can just plug my Raspberry Pi directly into the laser. Normally I'd need a separate controller, but this is a bit of a special laser. The laser cube, it's battery powered, so it's perfect for here. We're running everything on batteries. My Raspberry Pi is just running off a USB battery. The laser's got its own built-in battery. Don't know how long that's going to last, by the way, because I realized it was switched on in my bag the whole time here. So we'll see. I think it will last about an hour, but we'll soon find out, I suppose.
Is that the train? That's the London Victoria train?
And just because people will ask, this is a safe laser to use in a public environment, yes?
Yeah, I've taken all the necessary precautions. I've got all the paperwork. I sent you the documentation, Geoff. I trust you printed it all out.
Hang on, but Seb, this means that you've had to write code to do the thing where it kind of like scrolls up and then scroll left and do the little twirly line when it refreshes.
Yeah.
You had to write all that.
Yeah.
In what code? What's your coding language?
C++ thing.
So you don't actually type characters. You draw every character, right?
Yeah, I have the data for the characters as a bunch of graphical
sort of like preset.
Shapes. Yeah.
So you can feed in presets.
Yeah. So I wrote some code that you pass in characters to, and it gives you out a bunch of shapes.
Final thing, there's a gentleman here. This is a complete stroke of luck. I love this when I go to a random railway station and we meet the locals. Not only have we met a local, we've met the man, the artist. It's this tunnel here, he's going to tell us all about it and the NHS rainbow on the outside, because this gentleman is the artist that painted it.
I've been at it for like probably 10, 15 years, and it's always been street art. I think, you know, as a sort of offshoot of what Banksy was doing, but I had a very different way of going about things.
And tell us quickly, you obviously added the NHS rainbow as a recent addition. When did that happen?
Well, it had to be done, it was like quite early on in the COVID situation, so it had to be done really covertly at night, because obviously people were very, very sensitised about being close to each other back then, because we knew less about it. So I did a 4 o'clock in the morning job, and I had all the paints exactly set out in order with the rollers and everything, and it took about 22 minutes to do it. Whereas this lot I did last year, and it took best part of about 4 evenings.
Is it random, or is there a pattern to this madness?
No, it's completely, I'm a painter as well, so it's got a painterly feel, but there's absolutely no Nothing at all.
So, yeah. It's a beautiful thing. I can't shake your hand, but I'll give you a thumbs up, and we'll do like a virtual handshake. And we'll do, there we go, that. Good night.
All that kind of thing, yeah.
Seb, this is the point where you point above your head.
Yeah.
One, you go look at my laser, but two, plug your YouTube channel.
Yes.
And speak up as well.
Oh.
Subscribe to Seb.
Go and check out my YouTube channel. There's more laser stuff. There's more electronics things. There's basically all the nerd projects.
It's a nerd heaven, isn't it?
Come join me.
Subscribe to Seb.